Very, very good afternoon to one and all. First of all, let me acknowledge and thank the organizers for giving me an opportunity to share my thoughts. I will stick to my 10-minute schedule. Audit under GST. Very interesting topic. It's a newborn baby. First year we are going to have a... It's interesting because normally an audit period will be 12 months, but your first audit period will start whether it will be from July to March, or they will also include the pre-GST. This we have to wait and see. But my understanding from reading of the law is it will be a 9-month audit, not a 12-month audit. One good thing is they have retained the concept of audit in the pre-GST era, in the GST era also. Meaning they have recognized both the professionals, cost and management accountants and the chartered accountants to certify the GST reports, the GST audit reports. Now let me give a brief about how the entire structure is made in the law. Maybe we have been speaking about this opportunities in GST, opportunities in GST. One such opportunity is audit under GST. And mandatorily, it has to be done certified only by a cost accountant or a chartered accountant. Now, let me first start with the fundamental question. Why there is a need for a GST audit? They say for four reasons. One, two, three, four. Number one, turnover. My good friends, Mohanty Ji and Saswat Mishra, they were making some very, very good remark with respect to why e-way bill has come. E-way bill is not a GST document. It is a fundamentally a document which captures the movement of goods. And it is a document most vital for the department, not for the registered person. It is most vital for the department because they want to monitor from where the goods is going to where the goods is going. And friends, in audit under GST, the four main aspects are, number one, correctness of the turnover declared. And right from various documents, whether it is e-way bill, whether it is invoice, whether it is returns that has been uploaded, in all these places, the turnover is declared. Taxes paid, correctness of the taxes, whether it is paid, CGST, SGST, IGST, you have the UTGST. Refund claim, my good friend Mohanty was giving the nuances and the very critical issues in refund claim. And fourth important aspect is the input tax credit claimed. Because right from the first stage till the last stage, it is a self-assessment basis. My another friend will be speaking about assessment part, TK Jagannathan. It's self-assessment. And that is where there is a need for an independent audit mechanism. So this is the four main reasons why audit has been brought. Now, there are three types of audits that has been mandated in the law. One is a turnover audit. You cross the turnover, you have to get audit mandatory. Already I am supposed to get myself audited under Income Tax Act, let it be. Already I have to get my accounts audited under Companies Act, let it be. Under the GST law, the accounts has to be audited, Section 35(5). Mandatory. Every registered person has to get his accounts audited if the turnover crosses the prescribed limit, 2 crores. If it crosses 2 crores, that means 2 crores and 1 and above. Only the turnover audit is applicable. There is a section 44 subsection 1. which specifies that annual return has to be furnished electronically.
Wow.
And along with this annual return, along with this, this annual return has to be furnished electronically. We'll have a first year, there will be interesting issues. And maybe the last date is 31st of December. I am quite sure date will be extended. They say this annual return has to be furnished along with the copy of the audited annual accounts. Number one. So my form number is GSTR 9C, online form. I have to attach the audited annual accounts. Second, most important, maybe for cost accountants it is not new. Cost accountants, we already in cost audit, we have a mandatory compliance with respect to reconciling between the financial profit and cost profit. Financial profit and cost profit, mandatory reconciliation, and it has to form part of the cost audit report. And coming to a accounting part of it, accounting tax part of it, reconciliation over a period of 4-5 years, especially 4-5 years, it has become a routine. It has become a departmental routine. Why? Because under the VAT laws, the turnover will be there. Under the service tax laws, there will be a turnover. And under the excise laws, there will be a turnover. There will be a reason for a difference. The reason may be, under the VAT laws, my turnover will be inclusive of the excise duty, may or may not include VAT. But under excise, it may not include VAT. Service tax, only with respect to the services, I'll try to prove that income. And definitely all these three figures need not be same. And my financial statements may give a different turnover because I'm following an accounting standard. The department people are, they actually go crazy. So we use a dil to pagal hai. So they actually go pagal by looking at all these four figures. So they made it a point that whatever may be the figures, please reconcile and give, please reconcile and give. The notices used to pour that this is turnover under VAT, this is turnover under excise, why there is a difference, why not this be treated as a income and or as a revenue and tax has to be charged. This is one aspect. Now they have made part of the law. What has been as part of the procedures, nowhere it was a law, but it was asked as a voluntary procedure. Now it has been made compulsory. So under the GST audit, apart from auditing the accounts, one very, very important aspect is reconciling my turnover in the return and my turnover in my books of accounts. And that has to be certified and attached electronically. So this is a turnover audit. Number two and number three. Number two is departmental audit. Number two is departmental audit. That is section 65. And number three is a special audit. That will be done again by a chartered accountant or a cost accountant. First type of audit, turnover audit, is the arrangement agreement between the registered taxable person and the cost accountant or the chartered accountant. Fees has to be paid by the registered taxable person to the professional. Second type of audit is a departmental audit where the commissioner, the jurisdictional commissioner, either state taxes or central taxes. If he feels so, there is a need, necessity to have a departmental audit, he can order a special audit. And that will be in ADT 01. And 3 months time is given to the departmental official because the audit will be done by the departmental people. And the report has to be submitted 30 days after the 3 months is over. And coming to the special audit, the assistant commissioner will actually order the special audit with the prior approval of the commissioner. especially during the course of scrutiny, inquiry or investigation, if there is a necessity, even though the accounts has been audited under the various other laws, an audit can be ordered by the Assistant Commissioner and the process will start. 90 days is the time limit from the date of commencement of audit, and the report has to be submitted to the Assistant Commissioner. And this 90 days can be even extended for another 90 days with the request by the registered taxable person or by the chartered accountant or the cost accountant who is conducting that particular audit. And the audit report has to be submitted in ADT 04. Well, friends, this is in summation of all. And last but one point I want to make here, that compared to the pre-GST era, GST era, the GST audit may not look new, except for one aspect where mandatory reconciliation with respect to turnover and in the return and with respect to accounts. This we have been even doing it in the VAT audit also. This we have been doing it in the VAT audit also as an additional working sheet. But now this has been made part of the law itself, part of the law. Reconciliation statement has been made part of the law, and it has to be certified. Reconciliation statement has to be certified, accounts has to be certified. Along with that, the GSTR 9C has to be uploaded. Thank you very much for the opportunity. Special thanks to the organizers for making such a beautiful conference where the number of delegates is 700 plus, where the number of membership in Bhubaneswar is only 300 plus. Thank you, one and all.